We basically work on building driving intelligence for the vehicles. That means that we're trying to assist you while you drive. And the reason we call Drivebuddy is because that's like a virtual buddy you will have eventually when you're driving in any place, be it a commercial vehicle, be it a passenger vehicle. We basically are an ADAS and telematics company. We build a camera device, which is an edge-based device. We do a lot of computing on the device itself. This means when an accident can actually happen, my device can predict it and actually can give you alerts before the accident takes place. So that's the ADAS part of it. And then you collect a lot of data and it's in the cloud. So the cloud is basically where all the analytics happen. So as an administration of a fleet company, you will come to know a lot about the driver, you know, behavior. How is he? Like, you know, is he driving rash? Is he, you know, smooth? Is he driving beyond 8 hours, which is, you know, legally not allowed? Second thing is, a lot of accidents which happen are not sometimes for the driver's fault. How do you analyze that? So we give you data, we give you a lot of analytics on the back end to actually analyze those things, which is also helpful for the insurance companies for processing third-party claims. Typically, we are working in the commercial fleets right now, and the reason and how we're benefiting is because we're giving the drivers, the first thing is the drivers, the assurance that they're safe. Because most of the drivers, they are driving in the night, they are driving in very bad conditions. So my device can actually predict an accident before it happens. Second thing is, basically we are giving driver monitoring, you know, system to the admin. That means we are calculating the driver behavior. Is he rash or is he, you know, is he smooth? That is helping the fleet to, you know, kind of manage the fleet very well. They can incentivize drivers on the driving. They can, you know, kind of punish a driver if he's not driving properly. And that's how they are benefiting out of it. So the adoption challenge is the biggest challenge. India as a country is slightly slow in adoption that way because of various reasons. It's not a technology is not good. It is typically because the cost is the biggest factor, okay? And the need to do something. If I allow a lot of companies to use my product, it becomes very transparent. And then you can't hide things. So this means a lot of, you know, third-party claims which go into litigation, you cannot prove that it was not your mistake. So companies don't want to adopt unless and until it becomes a policy, it becomes a regulation. That's why we are trying to work with a lot of policy makers, you know, in the government of India to actually get it implemented. Our typical go-to-market as of now has been mostly to partner with a couple of hardware companies. Like I said, hardware is a cost. So there are a lot of companies in the market who are already making the hardware. We mostly focus on the software and the cloud part. So typically we kind of partner with any hardware company which is actually kind of in sync with us, and we run the software on the top and then we give the cloud services to the admin. We have just done pilots right now. We have not gone commercial in the market yet because, you know, again, we're trying to figure out the cost and the business model. And since the hardware company are partnering with us, we're still in the pilot mode only. But yes, the pilots are also very important because they're giving us a lot of validation that why someone should use it. So far we have done multiple pilots, the good ones to be in the UP government right now. We have a bus from Lucknow to Delhi which is having a device and giving us all the analytics on the data on the driver behavior. We are now funded, we have a couple of good investors coming on board, and this year's plan typically is to kind of, you know, now we have done the proving part. Today is the part where we actually go for execution. This means we want the Drivebuddy should be enabled in majority of vehicles. We're looking at almost 10,000 vehicles this year. This means it should be powered by Drivebuddy.
For more updates from CXO TV, please like and subscribe to our channel.